We know for more than 10 years now that the medical treatment of advanced hepatocellular cancer is sorafenib, and we use sorafenib for a very, very long period of time with some efficacy, but some toxicity too. Recently, in first line, lenvatinib showed equal efficacy than sorafenib, so this is another option for the treatment of the patients. But the median survival of the patients remains short, and there is a need for improvement of the results. The rationale of the combination of bevacizumab and atezolizumab is to combine an antiangiogenic agent, bevacizumab, that could improve a little bit the efficacy of the immune checkpoint inhibitor that is atezolizumab. So this is something that is very, very interesting in the development of the treatment of liver cancer, because antiangiogenic agents are working, immune agents are working, so to put together this synergistic drug is something that is very interesting. The design of the IMbrave 150 study is a randomized phase 3 study comparing this combination of bevacizumab plus atezolizumab versus the standard of care that is sorafenib. This study is following the very nice results that were obtained in the phase 1b study, evaluating the role of this combination, showing a 30% response rate and a more than 12 months of median overall progression-free survival. That is something very, very good. The eligibility criteria are quite simple, I would say. It's patients that should be treated with medical treatment for hepatocellular carcinoma. So it's possible to include patients with good liver function and an hepatocellular carcinoma that we cannot treat with TACE, for instance, or with surgery or for any this kind of option. We know that the accrual in the IMbrave 150 is very, very good. It's better than expected. So at this time, more than 50% of the patients have been entered in the study. So we imagine that probably at the beginning of 2020, we will get first results of this study.